one more motherfucking thing. Don Henderson, Ida Hutt, you two motherfuckers, I want y'all to do something for me. Y'all think I'm playing? I swear to God. What the hell? I'm getting it. And put this bitch in the freezer. Put this motherfucker in the freezer for 3 days. Freeze this bitch for 3 days. And we're going to pull that motherfucker out in 3 days. And I'm going to show you. Oh, Lord. Sara Lee's ain't got a motherfucking thing on us. I'm going to tell you some more motherfucking shit to do with it afterwards. Because I ain't got much motherfucking time. Because I told him this bitch, this video was going to be a motherfucker, right? Let me get this motherfucking shit. Goddamn. He gave us a motherfucking camera. Okay? So we don't got to be dealing with this shit no more. Goddamn it. Big Chad, that motherfucker. All these motherfuckers, all of them need to see this shit here. But Terry got to know how to do this kind of shit, okay? I got cut off for that other video because some son of a bitch want to call by the time I'm trying to finish my video.
No, I didn't.
Okay, let me tell you about that little motherfucker. That I got stuck on some shit this morning. I wrote that motherfucker on Facebook and asked him to help me. Motherfucking little baby boy just told me everything real nice and easy and used small words and everything. Went right in there and deleted them bitches. But when she ain't fucking with them kids, this is what I want all y'all to do. When she frees that motherfucker, now you gotta wipe this motherfucker with your hand. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. A motherfucking brush ain't gonna get it. That's it on that, okay? I think we done. I hope the fuck y'all like this one. Wait a minute, hold up. I gotta say something else. Shit.
What are you taking too long?
You finna hit the fucking button, shit. Hold up. When I say cut, then we know it's over with, okay? That's all I wanna say. Thank you and God bless all of y'all.
I'm back, yeah. It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangsta music, you get ripped to the
reed.
It's back, I'm back. It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangsta music, you get ripped to the
Mic check, 1, 2, what it do? What's going on, y'all? It's your boys from the Shoot from the Hip Show. My toy, Cerise, and his bad boy. And yeah, I hear you, dog.
You can hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
I've been hearing you.
Shoot from the Hip Show.
Yeah, oh. We in here. Yeah. I always stumbling out the gate, dog. That's a trademark.
It's all right, though.
All right. It's Shoot from the Hip Show featuring my toy, Cerise, and his thing. I don't want to feel like we're a little rushed, but we got to push it along because the Reese got stuff to do today.
No, you should have got here earlier.
Well, I mean, it's part of that, too.
Yeah, all that kind of motherfucker.
Hey, man, I was stuck in traffic, man.
You ain't had to go home?
Yeah, I did. Yeah,
what?
I did because I had to get the arms, man.
But
look,
we
got some upgraded equipment, man, because I'm trying to make sure Reese got the most efficient use of the mic when he's in his laptop. And now I'm getting chastised for it, man. What kind of stuff is that, dog? I'm looking out for the big picture here.
I hear you. You know what, though?
Nah, I don't know what.
It would have been nice if somebody would have donated to the cause.
Yeah.
I see how you motherfuckers is. Hey. Y'all some non-listed motherfuckers.
Hey, man. It's all
real
right.
Talk.
Oh, man. Don't be talking bad about the listeners, man.
Nah, fuck all that. They ain't gonna be listening, man.
Hey, man. They listen, dog. So, we get the feedback, man.
I know it. And I appreciate it.
Yeah.
You go ahead. Go to your joke.
Yeah, see, I was messing up my setup. I'm fucking around. Hey, but I got one, though.
Okay, go ahead.
All right, man. Hey, how you get a fat chick in bed?
How you get a fat chicken?
In bed.
Shit. You don't go to that Popeye's by your house.
Nah, that's not the answer.
Okay, go ahead.
It's a piece of cake. He's like, yeah, no, that wasn't funny. But Doom Ching anyway.
I think I missed that one.
Yeah, I think everybody else caught it.
I thought I heard you say chicken. You said a fat chick.
Yeah.
That's why I fucked up. That's why I said Popeye's.
Oh, see? So you listening with them Reese ears, man. You
I don't have my pop filter.
You pull your
you
ear
tell?
Muscle? Huh?
I don't have my pop filter. Can you tell?
Well, I mean, when you accentuate the pop, yeah, I can tell.
No, I can. I know it.
You can tell?
I guess so.
Hey, well, it's there a little bit, man. But it's all right. I've been working without one, and I need one, too.
Really?
Right, Bull Connor.
Man, you are deep. My
yeah,
toy.
Well, that is correct.
Yeah, so you don't need no motherfucking...
Hey, but these arms are cool, though, man.
Yeah, they look nice.
You know.
Feel a little Breakfast Club like.
Yeah, a little bit professional.
All that kind of motherfucking shit.
Yeah, that.
All right. That we back. Montoya's Reese. Shoot from the hip. 559-825 shot. 559-825-7468.
Yeah.
Shoot from the hip 1@gmail.com. For y'all that do not like to hear they self talk.
Yeah.
You scared, folks. But we still appreciate it had the same effect.
Maybe they don't spell real good and they don't want us
well,
to.
Well, that's the wrong thing. Oh, the email. We got spell check.
What I'm just saying, some people aren't proficient with spell check and whatnot.
Yeah. Okay.
So maybe they just, you know, want to be quiet participants.
Okay.
Nothing wrong with that.
Getting ready for the weekend. I got some real smoking.
Yeah, yeah,
good.
Man. Yeah.
They smell good.
Got like four of them on
shirt. Four racks, baby. All
right.
Racks on racks on racks.
Racks on racks. All right, just jump into it real quick, man.
Go ahead.
Rick Ross.
Yeah.
Dropped some fire. And I've never been a Rick Ross dude.
Man, that man been dropping fire since day
now,
one.
I can say that I've liked the beat selection. I've heard many of people say it over the past week.
Awesome.
It's like, you know, he's an excellent beat selector. I've heard that a million times this week.
Hey, man.
And I can't dispute it.
Just as
even late. Though I don't want to hear what he got to say half the time.
Why?
Because I know too much about it. That's why.
I mean, I like you fake, but I will say
that whole fake thing it deterred me early.
But I will say it does not bother me because I'd rather him be fake. And I do know this, that not many motherfuckers gonna fuck with him, and he ain't never backed down from a fight. You know, yeah. When it come to, you know, say motherfuckers fuck. You know, yeah. he ain't been Ja Rule,
but also.
And he can rap.
Every time I hear him, he's decent.
He can rap.
He's okay to me.
He can rap.
He's just okay to me.
Man, that dude got
hits. If you take them outstanding beats off of it, it wouldn't be that high.
I think it would take away from it, but I still think the rapper's
and his subject matter. Man, I don't relate to rich shit and selling dope. I don't relate to it. And now
how I can relate to it?
How's that?
Just watching TV.
Yeah.
I mean, because if you watch TV and you place yourself in a mythical.
Okay.
If you look at it from that perspective.
Yeah.
Like you're rooting for the bad guy in the movie or
I
something like
that.
That.
So, I can see that.
Yeah.
Well, all I can say is, man, he never really moved the needle for me. And sometimes I've seen interviews. I'm like, this nigga's a clown.
He always talking about being a boss.
Yeah, I'm a boss. Boss do boss shit.
Yeah, that's
and
him. This,
and I'm like, nigga, answer the question.
That's how he smooths his way on out of it.
It's not smooth. It's irritating. And I don't want to support that. But I got to say, this album here is on fire.
Man, all this shit been on
this
fire.
This is pretty doggone good.
It's my week. I might go with some Ross.
Hey, go with it, man. I can't say nothing bad about it this time, man.
I don't know if I want to go new.
He went
old.
In old baby a little bit.
Yep.
That didn't sound like some, I'm selling dope, I'm rich. And it's like it was some real life regular stuff. And see, yeah. That's, I'm talking about that. That's good.
That's the shelf life of a rapper though. They talk about all the dumb shit they done did and it kind of just fizzles out.
Yeah.
Once they start getting on that grown man, Jay-Z might be the only one that started. And he wasn't too gutter. He talked about his past. But his shit wasn't as ignorant. You know what I'm saying?
That's because he had a good flow to go along with it.
Yeah.
You know. But there's that, man. So let me back off of my Rick Ross dislike for a little bit, man. Because this one here is good.
All right.
Put out a hit, dog. And people will come. Anyway.
Check a text message.
Okay. Well, while you checking text messages, man, I got a little piece of tech news that kind of jumped out at me, dog.
Go ahead.
I don't know where. I don't know if it was just a theory being thrown around, but over there in the Silicon Valley and all that, they're trying to figure out a way to grow skin cells or regrow skin cells.
Really? Burn patients?
I don't know from where they getting them from. Or I don't know if it's just from injured people and grafts or whatnot. But what they found is that to just grow them in like a petri dish or something, they lack elasticity and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
And so. They came up with the bright idea to put the skin on robots with moving parts so the cells can grow with the elasticity.
Oh, yeah?
Sound like the beginning of the Terminator to me, dog.
Yeah, do sound like that.
But you listen to them nerds and geeks talk about it. They talk about it with all this exuberance and like they breaking through on something. It's like, dog, man, I know y'all seen the movies.
Yeah.
Every reporter I've heard talk about it. She's like, have y'all not seen the Terminator, dog? And I feel like we just going head first into it. Everything is AI. Hell, I got the Google Home and Alexa at the house, and I'm part of the problem.
Yeah.
But I ain't putting skin on robots, dog. Come on, they need to back up off that one, man.
Hey, man, that's what's up, dog.
Back off the skin on the robots, man.
The T-1000.
Yeah, that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Miss me.
It's hard to miss you, dog.
I don't know, man.
Shit, but anyway.
Yeah.
I got these ribs smoking, and I'm ready to fuck these bitches up.
Hey, man, you okay over there?
Yeah, I'm good. I had a burp.
All right. Hey, let it fly, man.
But anyway, the clip you heard at the beginning of the show, that was Auntie Fee.
Yeah.
And we're going to go and give her a RIP.
Yeah, okay.
It's so hard she to say died. Goodbye to yesterday.
All I know is she got a foul mouth.
Oh, yeah. She can cuss
like
with the best.
Like a sailor.
Remind me of myself.
Yeah, I was going to say.
The same cloth.
She used the same
our vocabulary
verbiage.
Is limited.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
I don't know if it's limited, man. You hold a good conversation without so much cussing.
That's when I can, but when I, you know, when I'm
but
in
when my, you don't have to, you just let it fly.
Let it fly. Right. Shout out to Auntie Fee. She blessed us with several videos. She had a massive heart attack and made me not want to try none of her shit.
Was she like a real chef or she was just some YouTube sensation?
She was a YouTube sensation, but she was doing shit that made some sense.
Yeah.
So shout out to Auntie Fee, you know. She probably cooking for them up in heaven, man.
Yeah.
Cooking for Pac
and
Biggie,
cussing and all that kind of motherfucking
Pac
shit.
Pac and Biggie just eating it up with her.
Yeah.
Eating some fried chicken,
old,
pork chop.
Them old mediocre rappers up in here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All that kind of motherfucking shit. You see that shot? I don't know if the, what do you call it, those motherfuckers on the right been able to handle it, but one of their God's gift to political drama and fuck shit, Tommy.
Yo girl.
Yeah.
Okay, what happened with her, dog?
She got suspended, and I guess being a conservative, she went against the grain. But she was saying it was hypocritical for her to be against government and all this other stuff, and then she said she was pro-choice.
Yeah.
And so she was suspended from the Blaze, which is ran by Glenn Beck, which is like, yeah. He's a big-time conservative and a Tea Party. I guess he's Tea Party guy, too.
Yeah, I don't know. I know once he got, I don't know if he got booted or what happened when he had his little show on Fox or whatever it was, but
yeah.
Then he went on his own.
Well, she gonna be leaving there anyway.
Is she?
But they went back.
She probably bigger than him right now.
I think so. And she that's part of the thing that they said.
She
and
got too big for a bridge.
I think she'll be on Fox next.
Little cute white chick, somebody gonna pick her.
She'll be somewhere. She'll be on Fox next.
Fox loved them little blonde haired white chick.
Oh yeah, big time.
Yeah.
You know. I mean, straight off of black.com.
So hey, black.com, hey, y'all owe us money.
Big time.
I know there's been an uptick in traveling.
Yeah, we didn't help them get a little traffic.
Yeah, traffic. That's where I was looking for.
Kendrick Lamar.
What did he do?
He dropped a single. And he said he was taking shots at Big Sean.
He ought to.
Why?
Big Sean is the boringest sound. He
really?
Sound like he laying down when he rap. He sound like he rapping straight from his pillow.
I think he pretty good.
And he is good.
Yeah.
I like verbally. I like lyrically.
Yeah.
Outstanding. But the delivery.
Yeah.
He sound bored in the motherfucker.
I think he alright. I think he's okay.
And up here he
I'm not his biggest fan, but I think he's pretty good. I think he can rap. Who I'm not a fan of is Kendrick Lamar.
See,
here's the deal. So
I was gonna say you're gonna have to.
The name of the
that.
Song is called "The Heart" or something about Part 4 or something. And he called out a few people. Let's see, he was talking about Big Sean, and he I guess apparently in a song that Big Sean said, he said he called out rappers that rap fast like they're having an asthma attack.
Okay,
so K Dot. Thought he was talking about him. So Kendrick Lamar came back and did his little shit he do.
Yeah.
And
there's a lot of people that do that though.
But you know what?
A lot of fast rappers. Like Tech N9ne is that's all he does.
But I don't think nobody just fuck with Tech N9ne. Like I think everybody likes Tech N9ne. I don't think Tech N9ne had too many.
He don't have much beef.
Yeah.
Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Yeah,
but I think
because he's in an alternate zone.
I think Kendrick Lamar is sensitive. I think he's overrated. And I also think that you know, these guys be taking all these shots at each other. Like, some of the shit he said, to me, I didn't agree with. It's like, so the way you talking is like you'll slap him on sight or some shit if you see him.
Who said that?
That's the way he, if you hear the song, that's how it sounds.
The Kendrick song?
Yeah. So I'm like, dude, like, and the thing about it, like him, like J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar, like they think they so dope lyrically and they be talking shit, you know, at certain people. But if you're going to do that, talk shit to everybody. Yeah, don't be around this bitch picking and choosing because you know motherfuckers who ain't gonna come at your ass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's why I don't like it. So if you gonna talk shit, nigga, be prepared.
What's the dude Detroit name again?
Big Sean.
Big Sean.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, man, I can't listen to Big Sean like that.
I can. I mean, I don't listen to him a lot, but if it's on, I definitely can listen to it.
I mean, that shit, man, I was like, damn, man, can you sound a little bit excited? Like you mean what you say? he just sound like, he kind of, because Drake does it. He sounds like Drake, like a bored Drake, because at least Drake a little bit can sound like, you know, put some inflection in there.
Yeah.
But Big Sean sound like, he rap better than Drake, you ask me, but he sound just like a bored Drake.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. I see what you're saying.
Right. I bounce back. Even though I'm born.
So let me ask you this.
Bounce back.
Are you a K-Dot fan?
Yeah.
You like Kendrick Lamar?
I do.
Okay. Well, I didn't know that.
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm not stand on it and preach it from the hill or nothing. But yeah, I think that dude is talented. And I listen to him, but on his last one.
I guess
one,
he has talent. It's just not my thing. I'll acknowledge the talent.
He went off the deep end a little bit on his last one. But yeah, even then, there was some parts I liked. Man, you know, he was exploring his artistic side and whatnot. And I ain't going to begrudge nobody doing that.
Yeah.
But if it ain't for me, then hey, don't wait for me to be checking you out.
Yeah, I'm just not a Kendrick Lamar fan like that. I acknowledge the talent, and the more I listen to his first, I'd never listen to his second album, but the first album,
yeah,
I listened to it, and it grew on me big time.
Yeah.
And at first, I was like, oh, this shit, I'm just not feeling it. But I have to do that a lot, listen to shit over and over again, yeah, before I pick up on it. But,
and you know, I think a lot of people don't have the time to do that no more.
Yeah. And you know, like that one song, I forgot what song he did with Drake. I'm trying to murder you niggas. Like, dude, talk some shit to motherfuckers who you know gonna come back and clap at your motherfucking ass.
I think he was just—he was trying to elevate the whole game.
I'm tired of the Drake disses, dog. Like, stop.
Yeah.
Like,
everybody dissing Drake.
Well, just like, dude, because there was like maybe a Drake, but they like more people was like, nah, it gotta be Big Sean. But my thing is, some dude named Extension and Drum. Like, dude.
He's speaking a foreign language to me right now.
Man, he got that song called Broccoli with Yachty.
Okay.
But anyway, like, dude, Matt, come at somebody that's gonna whoop your motherfucking ass.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man.
Why I gotta be all about that, man?
Nah, I'm just saying, that's just like me picking on somebody I know I can beat up.
Yeah, that's bull. Oh, speaking of that, dog, this just came out of nowhere.
Okay,
man.
Go ahead.
Okay, so when I was in sixth grade, when we first got to Mo City Middle School,
Murder Mo,
there was this older cat named Jack. Every gym class, he was a big old fat dog dude. And he picked on all the sixth graders or anybody smaller than him.
What's his name?
Jack. Jack.
Captain Jack to you, motherfucker.
He was a little bit, he might have been autistic. I don't know. He was slow. Something was missing. You know? But he still, like, had enough snap to be in the regular class with everybody. And he used to just bully random cats every day at, you know, during gym period. And then, man, when I took the old lady's car to get fixed on and I walked to the movies and all that, I stopped by Fry's over there on 59 in the Beltway.
Okay.
Jackass working at Fry's.
Oh, yeah.
I walk right past. He don't remember me because we never crossed paths like that. I used to just be on the outside looking like, why is he fucking with them?
Yeah.
Jack done had a long, hard road since we got out of high school.
Oh,
man.
Jack.
I seen him working at Fiesta.
Yeah.
I'm like, Jack, he don't remember nobody. Nobody liked him. You know, he was always in his own world, but he was damn sure picking on people back in the day. And so That you jog my memory. You talking about picking on somebody you can, you know, that might whoop your
you
ass.
You know what I'm saying? It's like a bunch of fucking nerds and shit trading shots. Like, get the fuck out of here.
They jacket because Jack didn't pick on nobody that could whoop him.
Yeah, and then you know, man, I'm just be sick of that rap. I'm just not a fan of rap.
Damn, Jack. Damn, what was that like? 20-something years ago.
Yeah,
Jack looked the same too.
Do it.
Space dot.
Yeah.
Like you know.
You know, people that's autistic that have hidden talents.
Yeah.
He might have a talent.
Don't know what it is. It's getting mediocre jobs at this point.
Come on, man. You talking about your own?
Hey, man. He working.
Yeah. See, there you go. He working.
But Jack was, you know, he had anything. I don't know what happened to him.
Yeah.
I don't know what was wrong with him when we got there.
Yeah.
Something wasn't right. That's all I know. Huh. And he was picking on people. And we was in the same little, we had our lockers. We was in the same little row. Yeah. He was a big son of a bitch to us.
Oh, really?
Like, I sure hate to get caught in the corner with this dude, man.
Man, hey.
No, I wasn't scared of him.
Yeah.
And I think he could tell who was and who wasn't. Mm-hmm. And so he left who he thought wasn't scared of him. He was
lacking something.
Something was wrong, man. I wish I knew what it was. But they sure stuck him in the class with everybody else.
And he was in your grade, huh?
No, he was before us.
He picking on the youngsters, too.
Yeah, we fresh out of elementary school.
He still working Fries?
Yeah, I just saw. I don't know how long he been there, because I saw him at Fiesta like 5 years ago.
He might be the manager.
Might be.
He might be head of the
Next time I go into Fry, I'm going to say, Jack.
Yeah.
Are you the manager? He might swing on me.
Now, if he ain't swing on you, then he ain't going to swing on you.
Yeah,
now.
Probably not.
Speaking of, you talked about tech earlier.
Yeah.
Then, you know, last time I had to slam that Galaxy shit.
Yeah.
But they coming out with Bixby.
Yeah.
You heard about that?
Yeah, I did. That's, you know, the team that came up with Bixby is the ones that started Siri.
What?
Yeah.
All
right. Yeah, they got bought out and they went over to Samsung. And,
oh, really?
Yeah. So they got a whole new shit called Bixby now.
So, well, usually people make fun of Apple for not coming out with shit first. Can we make fun of Samsung again for following, being third? You know, Google got it. Apple got it. What the fuck took Samsung so long?
Well, they've been trying.
If Apple came out with that, they're coming out with some shit now. You know what I'm saying?
They had S-Voice. But I saw you was all proud of them.
Nobody
red
talks
iPhone.
About
what's about? What's up with them red iPhones, man?
It's like, is it for cancer research?
Yeah, it's that Project Red thing.
There you go.
Yeah, they the last ones to the game in that.
I cannot unlock my laptop right now.
You done locked your laptop? I see you typing furiously over there.
Okay, I'm good. All right. Yeah. So
you better update of course. That shit. WikiLeaks dropped some. What's the word? Spam.
Oh, really?
Spyware, malware.
Yeah.
That can infect Apple products.
I don't shit that put be my careful. Shit up is porn.
Oh well. I don't know what to say about that, man.
Black.com.
Well, hey man.
Black.com.
Hey man, I'm gonna start beeping that out. We ain't seen no residual from that there, man.
It's coming, baby. It's coming. You gotta be patient, Ryan, here.
Yeah.
You know, you told me I dropped the ball on the turret clippers.
Did I tell you that?
It's hard to find a girl with fake. There's so much fake booty out here. But it what is. I'm coming out with is not. It's gonna be eye candy.
Looking like ants.
But hold on, I'm gonna call it something to look at.
Okay,
something to look at.
All right. So it ain't gotta be all about the fake.
It ain't gotta be the booty all the time. Clipping. It just gotta be something sexy or jazzy.
Yeah.
That's coming.
And
so
then we put the hashtag. Is the booty real?
Nah. It's not gonna be a big. She ain't gonna have a big dookie shoot all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Full of cement.
Yeah. with a tire, fix it.
Hey,
fix
ladies.
Flat.
Y'all ain't doing that for us. Y'all are doing that for each other.
Hey.
Hey, man. Did you see the Dave Chappelle stuff?
I watched the first one. I was digging.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah.
All right. I saw both, though.
Did you? What you think?
I thought it was funny, man.
Yeah, I think it's real.
You know he got in trouble with that LGBTQ stuff.
Which one did he? I heard.
That was on the first one.
Okay, I know. I'm trying to help me remember.
Well, he was like, he had somebody that, you know, his wife got gay friends.
Oh, I don't remember that part.
Okay, well, he started out with his wife got gay friends and they was, you know, hipping him up to some game about gay the gay plight.
Yeah.
It's like, hey, man, now they got some shit out here called LGBTQ.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's like, Q? I like Q is at, like it's in the vowels, like sometimes the Y.
Yeah.
Anyway, I ain't gonna tell the whole bit, but you knew, or at least I think he knew, it was gonna be some backlash with that.
Yeah.
You can't talk about gay folk and not hear it from a man.
You can't.
It's gay, it's part of the deal.
Run the world.
I don't know if they run the world, but they damn sure got a, well, one of them a say so. Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Who?
Tim Cook. You knew it was gay.
Nah, I didn't. Yeah, I thought Steve might have been.
No. Steve Jobs is don't, well,
he was a man's man.
He's not gay.
Yep. He was real, just a hard coat nigga.
You know what the thing about gay people? I be wanting to know if you top or bottom.
Hey, that was the other part. He was talking about taking the words man and wife, or husband and wife, out of the marriage law.
Yeah.
He's like, man, just talk amongst yourselves about it. And whoever's the most feminine, you the wife. Come on, dog. And it's so matter of fact. How can you be mad at that? I don't know.
I don't know, man.
I don't know. I thought she was funny to me.
I'm sure you did.
Yeah. And I know gay people don't really dig all that talking about them like that.
Well,
and you better I see you being kind of quiet about it. And that's a good move, because you are the most slanderous when it comes to that.
I don't slander. No? Just tell the truth.
Okay. All right.
I ain't said nothing that ain't. Man, I don't.
You ain't going on no trips with them. None of that.
I will go on a trip.
You can't be friends with them.
As long as my wife with me.
Okay. There you go. Got to have a chaperone.
You goddamn right. And you know that.
I'm bull calling it, man. I'm having a good time.
You know what? When I seen your wife last time, I should have asked her.
Yeah.
What she thought if you went on a trip with a gay guy.
She got a friend that's gay that we met for lunch or for dinner one time.
A dude or?
Dude.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Mm. They grew up together or something.
Okay, check this shit out. So I knew this girl, and we were our group of friends. And so I was feeling, I thought she was jazzy.
Yeah. But that was your friend, though.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
That's how I was back in the day.
All right.
But, you know, I told him, I said, you know, I kind of like one of y'all, but I don't want to mess this friendship shit up. Well, I had told him.
You
said,
told the whole group?
Yeah. I kind of told
boy,
him.
Boy, that's some respin right there, yeah. Boy. That's good shit.
But I told him, I said, why fuck up this friendship shit? We yeah. all hang. We go to happy hour. Why fuck this up?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I finally told her. I had
outstanding sit. Move, though.
She used to work in the mo. And so I sent some flowers to her job. You know, she didn't know who did it.
She worked in the mo? Was she from the mo?
No. She from Dallas.
All right.
And I sent some flowers to her job. And so we had hung out a few times and everything.
Mm-hmm. And did she know where the flowers came from?
Not initially. I waited like a day or two.
Oh.
And then
she figured out who the one was.
Well, I finally told her. So what happened was, so we started hanging out after I told her. So yeah, I said, oh, that's so cute. We hung out a few times. So she had a gay friend that she was real. I can't remember his name. But she was like, I know you don't like gay people, but if me.
So you've been that way.
What, no. No, I'm going to tell you why. So right. She said, his name was Stanley. Was it Stanley?
Stanley.
So she was like, I know you don't like gay people, but if we're going to be dating or seeing each other, you're gonna have to get used to this guy because he's gonna be around.
He's gonna be there.
Like, I don't have a problem. I do not have a problem.
I wouldn't have believed he was gay if I heard it like that.
Well, anyway, of course, nothing came of what we had going on.
He's trying to get in your draw.
So, I guess once the dude found out that somebody was trying to slide in there, that's when he got serious. And she wound up getting married. And that's all good.
Well, who got serious?
Whoever dude she was kind of off and on with.
Oh, so not Stanley?
No. So it was a dude. I'm just letting you know why we never made anything of what we had going on.
So homeboy
decided anyway,
to step up.
Here is why she thought I didn't like gay people anyway. So they had these wine and cheese parties.
I'm familiar.
Okay. Yeah. So what happens is, of course, you eat, drink, talk shit.
Yeah.
But you would get a piece of paper, write a question, bottle it up, throw it in the hat.
All
so
right.
Everybody pass around. And when it comes to you, you read it. Give your thoughts and people can respond. So one of the questions was, we was talking about something And I told him, I said, well, would you let your kids go spend the night at a gay couple's house? You know, when young kids spend the night, play games all night or whatever, or hang out. And I said, no.
Hell no.
I said, fuck no. I said, I don't want my kids seeing two two big dudes in the bed. I'm kissing and
big
stuff.
Big old bears.
Yeah, big old bucks. Niggas just laying in the bed together. So when the question was asked, I was like, who would let their kids go spend out a gay couple? I seen his hand.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. So that was Stanley in it. Anyway.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah.
So he like.
You met Stanley.
I met him.
All right.
So anyway. Just
At least he put his hand up.
That's
though.
My little LGBTQ or whatever.
Yeah.
Moment.
Yeah. See, it's too many damn letters, man.
Yeah, it is.
Come on, dog. It's all kind of the same shit.
Yeah.
It's an alternative lifestyle.
Big time.
That's it. Once again, I don't give a shit, man. If I ain't sleeping with you, I don't care.
What? Shit, you going to be sharing a room with one when you go to New Orleans next time.
I ain't worried about it.
You and the white friend going to be, y'all going to go to New Orleans together for the Texan game.
He's a gamer. We can play video games.
That's how it started.
Look, man, I'm too comfortable in my own skin, dog. It don't make me no difference.
That shit. You keep, nigga, wait, you drink?
Oh, man, I don't have no foul-ups behind that except for, you know.
Dude, you pass out, dog.
That's what I'm finna say, outside of passing
and
out.
And that's how it work.
But I don't pass out like that, dog.
You gon', hey.
I pass out when I'm sitting by myself in the backyard.
Well, you're not gonna be by yourself. So you gonna pass out.
So I probably won't pass out.
You gonna pass out with
your lady
friend.
I don't do that amongst company.
That ain't company.
Anyway, dog, he right past
I like
30.
How you changing that shit. Okay, we passed 30. Yeah. We are going to, let me give you some hot fire.
Yeah, it's Reese week for the hot fire.
My shit, keep locking up.
I got to refill the libation over here.
I got PP in the potty. We're going to play some hotness.
What is this I'm drinking? It's Frontier Bullet.
Yeah. So we'll be back.
Bourbon, Frontier Whiskey.
Bullet Whiskey, baby. We'll be back. Shoot from the hip show.
Baby, you a true thoroughbred. A born winner. I expect you to be magnificent.
Justice League.
It's the boss. It gets no better than this.
May that you.
Swimming in women, champagne sipping. Gold in the wet, June ends and all. This living is so magnificent. Stop dreaming it. Oh, love. I can show you. Show you better than I can tell you.
I'm the magnificent with the sensational style. Far from being shallow, cause she caught me with a smile. Try to figure out my style. Maybe that'll take a minute, but if all we got is time. You can't be acting timid, so we back to playing tennis. Meaning going back and forth. She the one that I adore. So I try to enter. Conscious in the veins, concentrating on my cream. I'm the king, make a move, pawns all the way to queens. I'm a don, I'm a boss, I'm a prophet. I'm a G, I'm a CEO, which means that I profit off of me. Yeah. All white tees, still rocking my neck ass. Fresh out of flight school, cause I'm fly right here. Yeah. Ain't nothing free, I'm charging the breathe there. If it's not on Maybach, really, who the hell cares? My money long, my money strong. If you ain't getting money, that mean you done something wrong.
Swimming in women, champagne sipping. Gold in the wet, June ends and all. This living is so magnificent. Stop dreaming it. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Sensational style down at all my automobiles with no miles. Yellow Corvettes, black rally stripes, and I never phone ahead. All she do is hit her pipes. Project upstairs kittens. For a minute, the night we count digits. Made back money, so I always had a vision. I would always tell my, but ain't nobody listen. Words work magic, haters wreak havoc. Ain't nothing on my back but the delicates of fabrics. I made a transition from the things to the biggest executive Def Jam's ever seen.
As they come down the stretch at Gulfstream, the magnificent and sweet tart coming down to the wire. The magnificent, sweet tart, stride for stride, and the magnificent wins it.
New York's dream, Sean John suit in the S dive ring. Sean Don for my crew, bad. The pursuit, mass pike on the tube.
He a glue goon with an attitude. How
swimming in women, champagne sipping, gold in the wet, Julian's in it. This living is so magnificent. Stop dreaming it. Come on.
Sensational style. When I decorate a home, marble flowing like the Nile. You a clown, here's the number you should dial. Yeah, start with 305, but we in it. Stop, I say the pound. For life is an old town. All them Garrett City killers, they're liking it broke down. Money is a must, Tommy guns on the bus. Alan Zamarin on the case, so you know what you could. Wear red all the time, but really I'm colorblind. Wanna catch my attention, throw up a dollar sign. One time for the young G's buying cribs, and I smoke with. When I visit Mississippi, the game never changed. Money still a focal, but it's time to the game. Like Puffy did total. Like Rev Run in the tub, still smoking. In memory of Shakira, boss gotta shout Oakland.
Swimming in women, champagne sipping, gold in the wet, Julian's in it. This living is so magnificent. Stop dreaming it. I can show you. Show you everything I can tell you.
Hey, what's up, y'all? Hey, that was another installment from The Reese, man.
Right.
What was that, man?
I can't hear myself talk.
Oh, shit. Okay. How about now?
I'm good. Okay.
Yeah.
That was magnificent. Rick Ross featuring John Legend.
Yeah.
Now, the reason I played that, it kind of reminds me of myself a little bit.
Oh.
Hold on.
Because you're so magnificent.
No. I mean, I am.
Yeah.
And excuse my humble brag.
Why is
but here's the deal.
Special Ed, I think it will.
All right. I ain't that cold. But, you know, a lot of times I've told y'all that I come from the hood or whatever. Come from not necessarily the greatest
upbringing.
You come
from the land where they play dominoes in front of the liquor
exactly.
store.
Exactly. All that kind of motherfucking shit.
All right.
But through my...
they fix your food.
Yeah. Well, okay, so here's the deal. I've been on food stamps. I've gotten free lunch. I've been embarrassed to get my free lunch. I lived in bad neighborhoods. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
You know, we progressed, me and my mom. You know, I grew up in a single parent home. But... just
y'all are a success story.
Well, coming from that to, you know, when I started my career and, you know, I lived in a small apartment.
Served your country the whole nine.
All of that.
You a whole book. You need to write one.
So when I remember when I was getting ready to buy my house and when I was getting ready to purchase my house, if you look up and down is my, you know, all of these houses, we were able to choose from whichever one we, you know,
right.
the elevation and different models.
Correct.
From this builder.
Uh-huh.
And we picked, and I was kind of, well, I'm like, damn, it's a lot of money. You know, I never envisioned that I would be able to afford some shit that I have.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I thought, you know, I would be getting me by the 25. 100 foot, 25, you know, square foot home.
Yeah, right
and,
on.
You know, the money looked right. So credit score was right. You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
And I remember when they first put the frame up, and I looked up, and I was like, because we were
like, God damn.
Well, we were the first. Our shit went up first.
Yeah.
And there was nothing here. All the shit you see.
So y'all are
here.
The pioneers on this block.
So I was like, God damn. I'm like thinking like. Man, I'm like, dude, I never in a million years thought, you know, and I remember looking at what our mortgage statement was going to be.
Yeah.
And our shit going up because property value going up.
Yeah.
And I'm like, God damn. I'm just like, so my wife's like, well, I want a pool. And I'm like, shit. So,
yeah.
You know, we got the pool.
Read
so
my man.
That was another motherfucking, that was more, that added on to the mortgage.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was just sitting out there in the hot tub one day, and that's what I thought of. I'm like, man.
Magnificent.
Hey, I'm like, say, dog. I'm like, man, I need to write a book because, and not that I'm living, I'm not rich, but I ain't hurting, and I think I'm doing pretty
rich,
goddamn.
Bitch, I'm barely broke.
Hey, yeah. So yeah. I feel like I'm doing pretty goddamn good. And I was also talking to somebody about my brother. And he's real materialistic. I'm not.
Yeah.
Man, I was just telling him, you know, this other guy, like, you know, the karma is we don't talk. And he introduced me to my wife. He helped get me one of my jobs.
Yeah.
Which I wound up kind of waving him out of the way.
Yeah.
And he's real materialistic. He's about having, you know, just
find a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, you know, I trumped his ass several times over. And it's not a brag, but it's just karma being that we don't talk anymore. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So
y'all hear them issues coming at y'all, right?
I'm not delving into that.
I was just asking about the song.
Well, I'm not delving into
this
that.
This nigga went to a whole diatribe.
No. But when I was sitting in that hot tub smoking my cigar, I'm like, dude, even if tomorrow the bank said, nigga, we taking your shit back. Or the IRS said, we taking this shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, I'm not done. But I just feel like I've done pretty goddamn good.
Yeah, I would agree.
Come from where I come from.
Yes, sir.
Shit, man. Say, dog. I wasn't supposed to make it. I was supposed to be Shutter Island. I was supposed to be somewhere doing some shit I ain't had no business mm-hmm. doing. Or I was supposed to be just going by statistics.
So right.
That song right there, you know, I was listening to that shit one day, dog, on my block rocker.
Yeah.
I like, shit.
Hey, it's a good song, man. I can't take that from it.
So anyway,
I can tell it was older Ross, though.
That's a little pat on the back of myself.
An extended pat on the back looking ass nigga.
Yeah, and look, and blessings. I mean, it's just been a blessing. That's all.
Hey, man, when you live it right stuff happens, man.
Right, right.
Square business. In the same vein, when we took our break, you was correcting your son's behavior a little bit.
Yeah.
And it reminded me of an issue I had with my daughter way early on.
Okay.
All right. And you familiar with the show Blackish?
Yeah.
All right. So the twin daughter, I think she was having some party or something.
Uh-huh.
The neighbors brought her a white doll.
Uh-huh.
And the mama was not having that.
Yeah.
No, we marched back to the store. We're going to get us a black doll.
Yeah.
And all they had was like Harriet Tubman and some Black Panther ass doll.
Yeah.
Well, it harkened me back to when my daughter's about your son's age.
Mm-hmm.
And I was buying dolls.
Yeah.
And I was like, nope, I refuse to bring a white doll to my daughter.
Yeah.
And if I saw one, I was replacing that bitch with a black doll.
Yeah.
Standing on that. Wasn't going to do it.
Yeah.
I really don't know exactly. I mean, of course, it's a black thing.
Yeah. A thing because
I would prejudice.
White people is not finna have no black dolls in their house. And,
right. I wanted her to have like positive images of herself mm-hmm. to come up with.
Yeah.
And so, and man, when you was correcting your son, I had a flashback. I was like, I know exactly what that's about.
Yeah.
Man, there it goes, dog.
All right. So, anyway. I do Facebook Live videos for the listeners just to step outside the box of what we traditionally do.
I should do a little more of that.
You did one.
I done one or two, yeah.
So I asked you motherfuckers. I said, look, call in. Leave us a message. Email us. I had a big surprise coming
show. I remember that.
You think I got one goddamn motherfucking message?
No,
you
man.
You think I got a call? You think anybody wants to know what's going on with
you?
You got to
check the numbers before you start. It's a method to doing the videos. You can't just hit play and then start talking.
Yeah.
If you ever watch somebody else do it, they wait about 5 minutes until they got their viewers up. Then they start talking some shit.
Yeah.
So that's what that is. All
right.
It's trickery, dog.
You ready?
I'm ready. Yes. All
right. So I think I got this ready. Hold on. Let's turn it down a little bit. And...
Hold on. If you're playing it through the computer, I need to plug you up.
Yeah.
All right, hold up.
Oh, yeah, do that. No, it's the other.
I'll put you both.
Okay. All right,
we gotta do voicemail in a minute. Yeah, let's see what you got, man. All
right. You know what that is?
Yeah.
What that means?
You got your nothing on the way.
Yeah.
I knew that when you said it.
How you know?
Oh, for whatever reason, I just said, this nigga got a kid on the way.
So my wife wouldn't get up one day. You know, I started trembling and shit. My toes started. I'm like, you got to get your ass the fuck up.
Uh-huh.
She wouldn't get up.
Nope.
Nah, so anyway.
Damn.
I know, right? So I just feel like I'm too old to be having kids.
No, you ain't.
I think I'm 38 years old.
Yeah, I know.
Shit.
Hey, you know my story. You ain't too old.
Well, see, you just got remarried, though.
Yeah. Hey, man, y'all building a whole compound around this bad boy.
No, we
never tried.
We ain't gonna never retire around this motherfucker. What's gonna happen?
Oh man, by the time, man, yeah, you will.
No, we not.
You have a child star out of one of them.
Man, by the time,
have a Disney kid.
By the time this baby grow up. College gonna be like $200,000 for like a regular fucking school.
Send ass to the military.
Nah, I wouldn't do that to
him. No?
Nah.
I hear that.
That is not our... Well, our Air Force and Navy is option, but that Army and that Marine shit, ain't happening. So anyway...
Did I tell a story about when I joined?
That was my big announcement, so y'all can give me the congrats later, motherfucker.
That boy Reese got a bun in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I knew that, though.
How you know?
I don't know. My gut said...
Your gut?
I got a big announcement. And I was like, man, it's not a whole lot of big announcements coming from this guy.
It's another karma thing because it's like I've been fucking with you.
Fucking with me.
Yeah.
Yep.
You got triplets coming, so.
Man, look here, dog. We went to that appointment, man, and they got to talk about the possibilities and then this and that. And I'm like, man.
Dog, I'll get you a car seat.
Man.
Hey, now that donate button, y'all need to quit fucking around.
It's like.
If the Montoyas have. Doubles. If he had twins or triplets, y'all got to get this man a car seat.
We looking at next month, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. So nobody knows.
Good.
Nobody knows.
Keep
so
it,
I'm letting y'all know
I
shoot from the
cool.
Head.
That's
no,
a but big one.
No, here's the deal though. So we supposed to do a Facebook Live this evening.
Oh, a reveal?
Yeah. So nobody knows right now.
Oh,
nobody on my side
wow.
know. My mama know, her mama know. Her and her boss knows because she might be transferring to a different location.
Wow.
So that's the plan.
Congrats.
Yeah, nigga, whatever.
Bring another one of you high yellow ass people in this world, man. Even this thing out.
So,
anyway. That's what I'm talking about, man.
So
good
that's
stuff.
Enough about me. Let's go to the voicemail.
Yeah, let's go to the
voicemail. We getting up against it.
Shit, here we are. Actually,
I got to leave here.
You got to burn.
About 20 after.
That boy got a bun in the oven, man.
I gotta be in the potty.
Now, you always gotta do that. But all right, this first one here, man, comes from the 702.
BTB, my nigga,
and
man.
You know who it is.
Man, next time I go to Vegas, I'm kicking with the BTB.
Exactly, me too.
Oh, hold up. Dad.
Okay, I'm gonna say, what is he calling now?
What's up,
nigga?
Y'all finished recording?
Nah, nigga, we still recording, nigga. Shit.
I'm on the recorder right now.
Yep.
Okay.
They know the drill
I'm
now.
Calls. I can see on the recording. What's up, everybody?
All right, as usual.
Sound like he waited for everybody to respond.
Yeah. you had your invite. I told you we was doing it, so I'll hit you back later, my nigga.
Yeah.
All right, nigga.
And all that
That's
kind of
BYT.
Shit.
Interrupting BTB. That's the pride of Baytown.
Yeah, man. There it go. But all right, y'all. Here it go.
Let's go.
Hey, we're going to die shoot for you, man. It's your boy BTB. I'm about to hit this Jack in the Box one time. Give me a little taco or something.
Mm, classic.
Right?
One time.
I had a question. It's a random shit. You know, it's an old-ass topic. But, you know, I just thought I'd ask y'all. Who y'all think killed Tupac?
That's funny since he out there in Vegas. I can understand that being a lingering thing.
I seen somebody like do a selfie from the block or the street that he got shot on.
Yeah.
If you ask me, I do believe the story.
Sure,
I believe the regular narrative that he got into it with a dude at the just based on his Tupac's action.
Yeah.
He chased some dude down with. And stumped him out, and I think the Crips or whoever came back to get it.
Yeah,
I don't know that Suge had anything to do with that. I know Puffy had nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
At least I don't think.
Yeah, I don't buy the rap beef at all.
Mm-hmm.
But I saw MC8's interview with V-Lab.
There you go. Yep, nigga.
Hey, man. Hey, MC8.
All I did was just co-sign what you already felt.
Yeah. Even though V-Lad, I mean, though MC8 was like on some you know, even though he got murdered by DJ Quick on that song and whatnot.
Yeah.
I never thought that he wasn't a real genuine cat.
Yeah.
Even though I didn't think he could rap that well.
MC8?
Yeah. Jeez. Oh, but he had the best beats though.
He had some that CMW.
Oh man. The whole thing, man. The last one with Straight Up Menace on it and
Yeah.
Oh man. What was MC8 featuring CMW?
That's the one I think I'm talking about.
He had the 8-ball on the table.
Yeah.
We Come Strapped.
Yeah.
I think is what it was. Whatever it was.
Yeah.
That was the
That's the one I had.
Oh, I wore that thing out.
I did too, man.
And I by that time, I knew what rap skill was and who had it and who didn't. Yeah, I hear that too. Yeah, all right. Yeah, and but when he was on that interview, dog, and he just said it, man, he was like, Pac, he did basically what Lil Wayne, Chris Brown, and Soulja Boy are doing now. Then he got hot. And I didn't want to get into some gang shit after the fact.
Yeah.
And so, you know, they being contradictive to themselves, and they got caught up in some shit they didn't know about. And yeah, I think that's what happened to Pop.
Yeah.
They got caught up in some gangster shit, and he from Baltimore. Stop it.
Went to high school
for performing arts and shit.
Yeah.
Not to say he wasn't smart, not to say he didn't have revolutionary blood.
Yeah.
But he's still on that dumb shit.
Hey,
and I'm sorry, I can't co-sign it.
He's a savage, man.
Hey, he was something. So yeah, I think Pac got killed over some gang shit. Uh-huh. Somebody trying to make a name. Now, I don't really believe Suge had a lot to do with it. Shit, I don't know. I don't even know who it was that got blamed for it.
This dude.
Suge Knight is the easy blame for that.
I had some on Suge.
And he might shit. I ain't gonna say he all the way didn't. Maybe Suge let them know where they was gonna be.
Finish that thought. I can't take it no more.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but yeah, maybe Suge maybe planted a seed. But Pac already had people mad at him by this point. And man, not even just the whole East Coast. You know, he had like people in Cali or on the West or whatever that is like, man, I don't like this guy. And he made himself a mark for that, man. You know, you can't be flamboyant. You can't be rich and then gang infested at the same time, dog. Because those two worlds don't mesh well. They gonna want what you got or want you out of there for flashing too much. And so BTB, dog, I think that's what happened, man. Now the Reese had to step out, man, because he's cheering down there making a little noise. And that's funny, because he gonna have like another one making just as much noise here in a minute, and he getting old and can't run up and down them stairs, and he gonna have a hell of a time in the next couple years. But yeah, that's funny. We gonna go on to this next one real fast, and I'm gonna have to catch Reese up with it. You know what? No, I'm gonna stop that. I'm gonna pause it, and we gonna be right back. Hold up.
Oh, that had to happen.
All right, so he back, man. Reese had to go take care of
BTB
little situation down there.
Yeah, man. BTB, like I said, I thought the story that I've been reading, it just sounded like it just right. Pac was being a knucklehead, and I think the Crip dude or the Crip did it. So anyway, appreciate that, Kyle, as usual.
Yeah.
We got another voicemail from...
Yes, sir. That's coming from the 209.
Okay, shout out to 209. Shout
all right.
To 209.
And here you go.
Hey, yo, fellas, what's happening? This is Jay out here in Cali. So I was watching, you know, little clips on Facebook and all that, as I do, because I don't watch the news, and we ain't got cable at the house. We rock that Fire Stick faithfully. Either way.
Unlocked.
What y'all think about this whole Colin Kaepernick thing, man? Like, my man can't get a job nowhere. At least as of me calling right now, I don't think the dude got a job either in the NFL quite yet. Because all these owners and that thing ain't trying to touch dude, you know, because of how he was rocking last year with the protests and all that. They're both all for, you know, a great cause, you know what I mean, to bring awareness to things going down in the hood. But, you know, rich white folks don't really live it. So all these managers and owners and all of this, man, they ain't trying to sign your boy, trying to get him a job. But he's out here doing all this activism and helping out all these different places, this, that, and the other. But, you know, some of the little news outlets were saying, you know, they let anybody who done drove drunk and killed somebody or beat up on somebody or had all these drug issues, this, that, and the other, yada, yada, yada. You know, they suspend them and then they put them back in the game. So, I'm wondering what y'all think about that, man. You know, Kaepernick not getting the job for kneeling, you know, standing up for his beliefs and bringing light to situations versus all these other dudes who got jobs but then beat their wife in the elevator and ran, you know, and got into all types of accidents and got all type of drug issues, this, that, and the other, man. So, there you go, man. I shot my shot. I want to know what y'all think about it. All
right,
I'll holler at you.
Hey, man, appreciate that, Jay.
Shout out to Jay.
From the E&J, the pit with E&J. The bottomless pit.
There you go.
And all that kind of
money. You want to hit it first or you want me to get it?
I mean, I go in there, man. I said it a while back. I mean, if you new to the show, you hadn't heard me say it, but I didn't buy that Kaepernick shit from jump, man.
You didn't buy him or you didn't buy...
I didn't buy him kneeling and stuff for solidarity and,
I think he was
and making a protest. I think when he stopped starting for the team that he had taken to the Super Bowl, he's feeling some kind of way.
I
sincerely think that.
I mean, you
and he hid it in the veil because at that time when he was doing it, there was a lot of activism and protest going on.
Right.
And so, yeah, you can very much, you know, hide it under that while you just pouting. And so you can talk about what he's doing now and all that, and that's cool. I mean, if you're gonna start something, you better go ahead and keep it going. And I don't even begrudge him for all that. I'm just saying that right out the gate, I didn't buy it that he was like legitimately protesting. I thought he was pouting. And so all them other cats, they got caught up doing what they did. They fessed up and they kept going.
Yeah.
Hey, he's still riding with the whole guise of I don't like what's going on in this country. Hey, man, guess what? That's not feeding your pocket.
Yeah.
Have a seat, bro, like you've been doing.
Yeah.
Just don't get paid for it this time.
Well, I believe that he played himself. You listen to Hot 97, some of the interviews, they got this little snippet that say, congratulations, you played yourself.
Mm-hmm. When keeping it real goes wrong?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
So, I will say that he played himself. I told this, and I know what's name tried to check me on it. DJ the DJ.
Yeah.
With a singer. Never cut off how you make your money. All of this shit that he stood for, all the shit he thought he was fighting for, none of these people give a fuck about him.
Nope.
Nobody care about him. Nobody is making a big goddamn fuck about him not getting picked up. You know why? Because nobody don't give a fuck. Yep. So what he did, he cut himself off and he wasn't able to make no money. He sat his ass down. But he fought for the people he didn't know. I mean, I understand, but when you trying to make money, man, fuck everybody else. Your number one thing is to take care of your house, not nobody else. Don't nobody give a fuck about you when you dead and go. Don't nobody give a fuck about you when you ain't relevant. So he's not relevant. Somebody don't give a fuck.
Exactly.
And he played himself. All the owners in the NFL are white billionaires.
Time to go to Canada.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Man, you had a cancel Christmas on
time
that shit.
Time to go to Canada.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Your pouting ass.
I do believe there was some sincerity.
I don't buy it. I never did. I didn't buy it. And now that the whole situation is kind of simmered down, now it don't mean shit to anybody.
I just feel that the dude, you know,
I said it before,
never play
man.
Yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Congratulations. You played yourself.
Exactly. He played himself.
Oh, wow.
And
now that was good production.
I'm just saying. DJ, I'm telling you.
Boy, we about to have some shows out this bitch.
DJ, I'm telling you. He played himself. Yeah. Fighting for some motherfuckers he didn't know. And I got a lot of shit I want to kick to. I don't have much time. I got to get ready to get out of here.
Yeah.
I want to say this, that the Justice League trailer was out. I'm very interested in checking
that. The Justice League trailer.
Yeah, check that out.
I hadn't seen it.
Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman.
They've been leading up to it.
Daredevil, they have been leading up to it. And shit look like it is hot fire.
I'm all in. I don't even need to see the trailer.
Remember, I'm going to be dropping that. Something for you to look at. Stay on me. Help me out. I'm going to need your help.
Oh,
so when you drop the show, let me know, and then I can look up something quick and I can post her.
Okay.
The Iron Fist was released on Netflix. I heard bad reviews for it. I have not watched it. Have you watched it?
I watched the whole thing.
God damn, is it good?
Yeah, I liked it.
You watched it? Is it better than Jessica Jones?
Yeah, oh, 100%.
Okay, so now I got to check it out.
Yeah.
Rick Ross and Drake released albums. We talked about Rick Ross. You said you...
Yeah, I like Rick Ross.
Drake,
I heard it wasn't that good.
It's not that good.
I heard it's like wasn't even rap.
It was not.
So I'm out.
Very disappointed. I'm
much of the same far and as I'm concerned.
I don't dislike his singing that much.
I ain't listening to none of that.
I tried to. One of the things that I'm going to try, I'm trying to start watching every movie that's nominated for Oscar.
Okay.
And all of these rapper albums that's considered great albums. I listen to Chance the Rapper. Absolutely suck.
Yeah, I wouldn't give him a chance. When I heard the first single, it was
oh my God.
A bunch of dreadhead niggas in the lobby.
Hey, listen,
I was like, man, nah, I'm out.
And the Grammys.
Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Don't ever play yourself. Congratulations. You played yourself.
That's what I'm talking about.
I do not know which direction rap is going in.
Hey, man, you doing hot shit over there. I see you.
I'm going to tell you that shit is not what's up. And I'm not against positive stuff, but goddamn it, that shit is horrible. A lot of shit got all these features, and I don't even hear the motherfuckers.
Hey, you hear how fast he talking?
Well, I'm trying to close this shit out.
Hot take ass.
I'm trying to close this shit out real quick.
All right.
Today, when I leave, me and my wife both do a Facebook Live. We do not know we having. It's in the envelope seal downstairs.
Y'all already got the gender thing?
We have it in the envelope.
Are you going to have a gender party?
We did that for my son. So we're not going to do
that. That's right. I remember that.
And I want to play this real quick. I got to get the fuck up out of here.
Yeah, dog. But you show you done got your juices flowing now.
So let's see. Commercial. Anyway,
I want you. Red, you can deal with that.
Fuck all that. I spent enough money on other random shit.
All right.
Listen.
I'm listening.
Turn that shit up, Jack. Or somebody gonna die for big soon, nigga.
Oh.
I promise you that, nigga.
Whoa.
TMG, ATM, the unit, nigga.
That's Uncle Murder. He said this on the Breakfast Club. He wanted blood a long time ago and Biggie died. This the ignorant jump. This nigga's 40 years old, right?
Boy, you signed made a hell of a jump, baby.
Signed to G-Unit. I hate 40-year-old niggas that signed to another
next
nigga.
Time, dog, start the show with this shit, man.
Okay, well, I'm just saying. This dude is a clown. Him and Tex Tone igniting more bullshit. Who you gonna kill? Somebody gonna die because that mean they gotta kill somebody on the West Coast. Who you gonna kill?
They gonna, whack 100. They gotta get it.
That might be.
They gotta get it.
He fuck with Wack though, because when the game came and shot the video in Brooklyn, they fuck with Wack.
Yo, they finna go to the West Coast to start poking niggas.
But you see how dumb shit. That only happens in rap. Beef only happens in rap.
Crab I don't know. I bet the country music dudes go.
Ain't nobody. Killing
I bet they
nobody.
Go ham at a NASCAR.
No, they don't, man.
You ain't been there. You don't know.
I see some shit.
I saw Ricky Bobby. It wasn't all fun and games.
I seen some shit on T.I. the other day I really want to get into, but we're not going to get into that. I am going to close
about him being hypocritical. And
he is a fucking huge hypocrite.
Yeah.
559-825 shot. Give us a call. Appreciate the BTB.
You don't know me.
Appreciate Jay, Ian, Jay, Erkin, Jerk. Shout out to the Bay Area. Well, close enough. Modesto. Yeah. Shout out to Modesto.
Northern
shout out
Cali.
To Vegas. Appreciate your BTB. Appreciate all the listeners. I'm disappointing you all for not calling and trying to guess what my shit was.
Man.
Pray for me. I'm 38 years old. I don't need to be having no more
You
kids.
All right. You in the prime of your life, man.
You going to have triplets.
I'm good. Okay. I'll take it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm straight.
Okay, so here go my wife right here.
Penna.
I'm going to let you close it out. I got
to
go.
Hey, yeah, I'm about to close it out, man. It's a shoot from the hip show, man. It's from the _ hip on Twitter. You can reach me. That's Montoya's at Montoya's K on Twitter. That's MONTOYISK. And you can catch my boy Reese on Twitter at Man at Arms on Twitter. That's MANN_AT_ARMS. And hey, y'all, holler at us, man. Check the Facebook page out. Like it. Reviews and stars and likes and shit. iTunes, all the other ones, Stitcher and whatnot. Hey, go ahead and give your boys a shout out, man, and holler at us, man. If you don't like it, tell us what you don't like about it. If you dig it, tell them why you dig it. And that's gonna do it. Roof. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Hey, time, come on. North side, come on. Come on. East side, come on. Come on. South side, come on, south west side, come on, Mo City, come on, what A town, come on, what Bay town, come on, what BA, come on, what Philmore, what Bonehard, Ross Ness, no stress, I'm talking about.